Hey, I'm Richie Castellano, and today I'm looking at the HX Stomp from Line 6. In this video, I want to attempt to make three presets, basic presets, for a Strat, a Tele, and a Les Paul. And the idea behind these presets is that you can just plug directly into this, into a PA system, and be able to do a gig just on this one preset. And I'm gonna call these presets Basic Ritch. Get it? Okay, so I'm not gonna use the HX Edit or any expression pedals or foot switches or MIDI controllers. Everything I wanna do is gonna be self-contained. One thing that's gonna be a little different about these presets is that I'm not going to be using distortion pedals. I'm gonna use amp distortion. And I want to be able to switch between a cleanish sound and a dirty sound without using pedals. So I've thought about this and how I wanna do it. And the way we're gonna build this is with a cab block and two amp blocks that we switch back and forth between. Now, I'm not gonna use any external impulse response for this. The point of this is to be self-contained. Okay, before we get started, I just wanna point out one thing. The way the HX Stomp defaults is this third button here is a tap tempo and a tuner. Well, just because we only have three buttons, I'm gonna replace this with a regular stomp, and you can use a clip-on tuner or whatever, but I'm gonna get rid of the tuner here because we need the real estate. So to do that, you hit page and page together to go to the menu here, and we're going to page over to global settings, and I'm gonna go over to foot switch 3, which is this function, and I'm gonna change that to stomp 3, okay? Another thing that might help you to do, especially if you're going direct, is change the output level from instrument to line. This is good for going into a PA or your interface. Instrument level is really for going into an amp. So let's dive in. So I'm in the view, the preset view here. Let's go into block view. And if you use the top rotary encoder, you can scroll to all 6 points and the input and output block. So right now I'll go right in the middle and I'm gonna start with a cab. So I'm just gonna click, push this button in, and I'm gonna scroll down to cab, single cab. And the one I like, my favorite cab in here, is the XXL V30, okay? And I like it with the ribbon mics. So I'm gonna start off with this ribbon mic. So let's listen to what we got. All right, that's cool. Now use this knob to scroll left and right. And right before this, let me start with my dirty amp because that's a little more fun. I'll push in here, scroll down to just amp, not amp and cab, just amp, guitar. Okay, so let me take a look at some of the dirty amps I like and we're gonna listen to them. All right, I like Placator Dirty, so let's see that with my Strat. That sounds pretty awesome. Let's try some other ones. Oh, I like this one. Archetype or archetype. I don't know how they say that. Lead. That sounds great. Oh, angle meteor. I love that, but it's a little too much for what I have in mind. Let's try solo lead OD. That sounds great. I think I'm gonna go with the Placator just because I know it and it's got a good rhythm sound and a good lead sound built into one. So I'll push in to select that. So now let's go to the parameters here. I'm getting a little bit too much thump. Let me see if I turn the fat off, if that makes a difference. Oh yeah. Now to go back and forth between these parameters, just use the page buttons. I might take the drive down a bit. So now I'm gonna bypass this by just pressing the top button in, the top knob in, and I'll scroll over here to this empty space. Now I'm going to try to find a clean sound that works with this cab. Push down, back down to amps, guitar. Ooh, that sounds good. Now, I do like having a totally clean amp, but for the purpose of having it be multifunctional, I'm going to find something with a little bit of grit, so we can always roll back the volume to clean it up. That's too clean. I like the deluxe, that's cool. Let's see what else we got here. The AC sounds good. That sounds really good. So that's the winner so far. I also like the matchstick a lot. That's like a little bit more of a tamed version of the AC, I think. I'm gonna go back to the AC for a second just to compare. That sounds really good. So I think those are my two amps. So now to switch between clean and dirty, I want to use one of these foot switches. Okay, it's pretty easy to do actually. So let me bypass that. Put that on. So, okay, to assign a block, let me explain how to do this instead of just doing it. So you pick the block, and see how I'm scrolling between the blocks here? You pick the block you want to assign. So let's say this one, Placate or Dirty. All I do is touch the capacitive touch foot switch, don't even press it in, and it asks you, do you want to assign it here? And you say yes. Great. But that's not going to help me because I want to toggle back and forth. So all I need to do now is scroll back to the other amp, assign that as well. So check this out. Clean, or sorry, dirty. Clean, dirty. So it's going back and forth between the two amps. Now, if you want the state, like, so it doesn't help me to have clean lit up. So all you do is tap it again, and then it goes back and forth between that. All right, so now I have to level these out and match them a little bit. Because obviously the AC is way louder than the Placator. So let's go to the Placator and try to... Actually, you know what? I think I'm going to make the AC lower. And I might take the drive down a little bit. It's a little too hairy. Still super loud. All right, I'll bring this down a little more. And now I'll kick up the Placator a bit. Push it, oh, it's masters all the way down, so. There we go. Now another thing you'll notice is we have some noise. So that's pretty easy to get rid of. I'll go all the way over to the input block, turn the gate on. Now I like a pretty fast decay for the gate. Now, the higher you make it, the more it clamps down. It's a little too much for our clean, so I'll lower it to get some tone back here. All right, so now let's add some other fun stuff here. One thing I like to have that's sort of a great you know, basic effect is a chorus, and I like having that most of the time before the amp, but we can experiment with it. So let's scroll here. And let's throw a chorus in by pushing the second knob, scrolling down to mod. Let's go to mono. Now you can really swap this out for any effect that you prefer. I just feel like a chorus is a good starting point that really covers a lot of bases. That sounds nice. It's a bit much. I might just take the mix down a little. All right, I'm going to assign it here just by touching it. Hit OK. Let's see how it plays with the dirty sound. It sounds weird with the dirty. Let me try moving this. So we're still selected on the chorus. I'm going to hit action, and I'm going to just turn this to move. And I'm going to put it between the amp and the cabinet. Let's see what this sounds like. Definitely sounds better for the dirty. Let's see if it works for the clean. Still sounds nice, so I'm gonna keep it there. Cool, so let's add a delay. You could do reverb if you want. I like delay a little better. Push down here, scroll down to delay. Let's keep it mono for now. You could do this stereo too if you prefer. I'm just trying to make this as basic as possible. I'm a big fan of vintage digital and transistor tape. I think I'm gonna keep it with the transistor because it's got a little more vibe. Make it faster. Whoops. Be careful of that. If you accidentally touch one of these while the capacitive mode's on, you'll go to that effect. And I'll put that here. Yeah, too much feedback for my taste. So let's lower that. Cool. Now we have one open block here. That doesn't mean we have to use it, but I think I might use it because I have an idea for something I want to do with that. So let me kill these. One thing that's really nice to have on a clean sound is a compressor. So let's see if we can add that here and if we can get away with using it. So I'll push down here, go to dynamics, mono. Ooh, kinky comp, I like that. Yeah, it's a bit too much, so let me go back and pick something else. Let's try this deluxe comp. Now, what I like about a compressor is that it can keep the dynamics right at that sweet spot where the amp is about to break up. It's a little too much output. And we can even do a little parallel compression just by bringing this down. So let's try it without it. So the problem I'm having is when I roll off the volume a little bit, it kind of goes away, you know? Like loses all the tone. With the compressor on, if I lower the volume, it retains some of that tone. But now we have to be able to switch that because I don't want it on with the lead sound, which is a bit much for me. I don't like playing the leads with the compressor. That's me personally. So what I'm also going to do is scroll back over to the compressor, touch this, assign that to this foot switch as well. So now these both the compressor and the AC turn on at the same time. So that placator is starting to sound a little muddy to me by comparison, and I have it pretty much, I have the treble up pretty high. So I might change that. Let me do this, because I'm not sure if I want to change it, and I don't want to lose my settings. So first thing I'm gonna do is save. So I'll just press both of these, the view and action, hit save, right? Then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hit action here, and I'm gonna copy this block. And I'm doing that so if I go back to another amp and I decide I like this one better, I can always bring that back. So let's try that. So I'm gonna scroll to... It's also kind of muddy. Not muddy, but really bassy. I think the solo lead sounds great, actually. This might be more of what I'm hearing in my head. Let's give it a little more drive. And it's got plenty of room to go with the treble if I want it even brighter than that. Nice. And then back to this. I might lower the output of the compressor a little bit because it's breaking up a little too much. So let me go here, lower this. Now, if that's too much breakup for you when you download this preset, you can do whatever you want with it. You can lower the gains, you can change to a totally clean amp. I just wanted to have some more flexibility in terms of how I play because, you know, like I said, if I want it to be clean, just, you know. If I want it to be dirty. So I have the option there, and if I want to really go nuts, I just hit the gain. Totally different amp, sounds great. One thing I am noticing is I'm getting a little bit of that high-end fizz, just a bit, and it's not necessarily a bad thing, but we can do something to get rid of it. So we're gonna go over to the cab block and go to the high cut. And I'll bring this down to like 10 or so. Maybe a little lower. About that, I'm gonna leave it here, and you can do that to taste. All right, cool. So let's name this. So I'm gonna hit save, and we're gonna name it. This chooses where you're gonna save it, right here, down here. So we're gonna save it here. This scrolls, and this is how you pick the characters. There we go. So there's basic Ritch Strat. I'm gonna tweak that amp a little more because I'm a crazy person and this is what we do. All right. Here's something a little nutty I'm gonna do, because I can. After, you know, taking a little break and listening to it, that just has way too much hair on it, like high end. And I don't wanna mess with the high cut on both, so I'm gonna do this. Check this out, this is a cool trick you can do. So I'm gonna go over here to the high cut. Now here on the clean, it's fine for 8, but watch this. I'm gonna push down and hold, and then I'm gonna do next page and hit learn, I'm gonna press that switch. Okay, so go to the next page. The minimum value when it's off is gonna be 8K. And the maximum value when it's on is gonna be, let's do 4K. Okay, so let's see how that works. So that's too much. So I'll just hold this down, go back there, I'll bring it up. Solved my problem there. Now I can have a variable high cut depending on what sound I'm using, and that's all assigned to this foot switch. So just to review, I have assigned to this foot switch a compressor, two amps, and the high cut on the cab block. So it's pretty impressive. Okay, so now we have to do one for a Tele. Okay, let's save this to a new location. So I'm gonna hit save by pushing view and action together. And then I'm going to use this bottom rotary encoder to go to the next preset. And I'm also going to change the name to Tele. Okay. Now, let's get a Tele. There we go. That was easy. All right. So let's see how this is working for the Tele sound. You know what? I might want to do a different amp altogether for this. It's not bad. So I'm going to save this first in case I want to go back to it. So copy it. Actually, I really like the way the Placator sounds as a Tele. So let me pump the volume up a bit. Make the delay a little different for this one, just to be different. Make it a little faster. I think the lead sound needs to be a little louder. And since Teles are inherently brighter, I might go to the A30 here and raise the cut up a little bit. might go over to the cabinet block and put a little bit of the low cut on here. That's just a good practice to clean things up. So I'm going to save this. I'm happy with this. Let's hear the chorus first before I say that. You know what? Let's do something different for this. Why not, right? I'm going to do, and you can do this however you want. I'm going to do a tremolo. I think that's nice for a tele. You can use it if you want to. Now check this out. Here's a cool trick. I'm going to save this. Now let's say you get these presets and you really don't like tremolo. You'd rather have that same chorus. You can go back to the back to view here. You go back to the Strat, right? You go over to the chorus. You hit action, copy block. Okay, go back to view. Go back to the tele and back to view. Scroll over to that, the trem. Hit action again, paste block. So now we have the chorus back. So it's really any way you want to do it. One thing I might do is go back to the Strat here, now that I'm thinking about it, and go back over to the cabinet block and put that 80 hertz low cut on just to clean things up. Doesn't hurt. So we'll save that. Good. Okay, so now we have to copy this. I'm going to copy the Strat to a new location. So let's hit save. Use the bottom knob. Go to an empty spot, hit save again, and let's get a Les Paul. Okay, so we have the Les Paul. I'm not expecting the Les Paul to work with the Strat preset, but you never know, so let's take a listen. Okay. So yeah, it's really not working. This really won't be able to clean up. So I'm going to have to do something really different for this. So first thing I'm probably going to do is, because this is a darker guitar, is I'm going to pick a brighter cabinet, or at least a brighter microphone. So I'm going to go over to... I'm gonna try the 121 ribbon. Let's see how that works. Let's go through some of these amps and see what really speaks to us. I'm gonna click down here, go through the list here. I might want a Fender-y sound here. That's nice. That's not bad. That sounds pretty nice. That's nice, it's a little too clean. I like the Litigator because the neck pickup doesn't sound muddy with it. It's like the only model that it doesn't sound muddy with. Let me see if I can mess with that a little bit. That sounds cool. Let's put the compressor back on and see what that does. Little too gritty. All right, that's nice. So let me assign this. Okay. Now let's go here. That is not working for me at all for this particular guitar. So let's see what we got here in terms of lead amp options. No, not digging that for this particular sound. That's cool. I think the angle meters are the winner here. Also, I'm partial to that amp. I'll assign that here. Good. So we have to fix that volume difference. I might want to brighten up the Meteor a little bit. That's cool. Let's see what the chorus sounds like. Sounds nice. But just to be different, let's switch it up a little bit. I love flangers, so I'm gonna put one on here. Or maybe we'll do the vibe. Nah, flanger. Let's try it with a delay. That's working for me, that delay, too. A little too hairy, I think, that distortion. Let me see if I can pull some of the presence off. Anything, any other? I think I like that mid boost. What's cool about the Les Paul with this particular amp setup here, I think this is the Litigator, right? Yeah. When you have it in the neck position, it's got that sweet sound. In the middle position, you could do some rhythm. And then you have like total twang here in the bridge. I might want to compress this a little harder. Let's see. And that's it. So there you go. I will make the links to these three presets available below in the description. So feel free to download them. Let me know what you think in the comments. And also play around with this. This is a platform to do something a little different. I know most people like to do, like an amp that's sort of clean and then a bunch of drive pedals. That's just, you know, me personally, I'd rather have, you know, multiple amps because this could do it. And, you know, even though this has a limitation with the amount of blocks you can use, that really shouldn't stop you because you can use the one cab with the two amps. And I hope you learned something from this video. I did a few of my my Helix tricks here that worked on this like a charm. So if you did like this video, please give it a like down below and subscribe to my channel so you don't miss any of the new videos I'm going to do. I do more gear videos. We do music videos, live performances. We do a bunch of stuff here. So we'll be happy to have you on as a subscriber. And thanks for watching.